project we are currently working on, which is not strictly related to the topic of the conference, but it is nice because I'm working on chain memory loss, and this is a very nice application. We are working on the development of ultra-high vacuum couplers based on chain memory alloys for applications in particle physics, and in particular in particle accelerator. This is the results of a joint project with the European Organization of Nuclear Research in Geneva. And the idea is, okay, the needs, this slide summarizes the needs we have at CERN. You know, the CERN hosts the largest particle accelerator in the world, and to avoid collision with gas molecules within the beam pipe of the accelerator, the particles should travel in a vacuum which is similar to the interstellar space, and it means that vacuum is a very important need. So there is another constraint. Radiation doses in some critical areas of the particle accelerator are so high, so that personal intervention and should be limited. And this is why we started with this nice idea to replace the current technology for coupling, which is the standard bolted junction, complat junction, complat flanges, which requires time for maintenance operation, mounting and dismounting. We are trying to replace this system with a kind of smart system made of chain memory alloys. It is actually a ring, which has the special properties to modify its internal diameter simply by changing the temperature. And the main advantage of this system is that it can be controlled remotely. You can change the temperature remotely without the intervention of a technical person. So this is what, let me go. The operating principle is very simple. We have a ring which should be thermomechanically trained in order to give it the shape memory properties we need for the application. So once the ring is trained, it can be mounted on two pipes for a connection, pipe connection. Then when it is mounted with a certain gap clearance, it is heated, heating causes ring contraction, and due to the high force recovery capability of the material, it is able to apply a very tight, high pressure at the interface. And the idea is to exploit these properties, the high pressure generated at the interface, to close any possible leak path. And consider that here the leak tightness should satisfy, the leak path must be smaller than the helium molecules, because of the fact that helium is largely used in the beam pipe, as you know, because it is used as a refrigerant. And okay, just for information, okay. We have developed a training process for the ring, which is basically, so maybe this is the only link we have with the topic of this conference, which is based on, let me say, severe or extreme condition, thermomechanical condition. It is made by high temperature treatment, basically a full annealing treatment, close to 10,000 degrees, then cryogenic expansion at temperature sometimes close to minus 150 degrees, and so on. Okay, but I will not give details. After that, the material, the ring, is smart. It has the ability to contract and enlarge when heating and cooling. So we did measurements to measure both the so-called free recovery capabilities, the possibility of the ring to change shape when he's free. But we also measured the so-called stress recovery capabilities. I mean the activation against a steel pipe, which is a condition very close to the real condition application, and we have measured estimated the contact pressure by strain gauge measurements. We have also used the AC, and okay, this figure reports the free recovery, but I will not give detail about that. This is very nice. These figures report the results of contact pressure at the interface. This is for a ring with an internal diameter of around 45 millimeters. And as you can see, the ring, we can obtain maximum pressure around 80 megapascal. And we have also demonstrated, verified the dismountability. It is a very important need. Okay, the ring should be able to, should allow dismounting. But as you can see here, dismounting is obtained when the pressure is close to zero at very low temperature, around minus 150 degrees. And that's why these are the results obtained by using a ternary system, nickel, titanium, niobium. That's why we moved to another system, the more common binary system, nickel, titanium, which is in which the, okay, we have basically properties, better properties. I mean, here, dismounting is obtained at a temperature of around minus 30. And it is an important point, because this is the temperature which allows dismounting, and time exposure is directly related to the temperature during cooling. We did also some activities to optimize the contact surface in order to maximize the sealing properties of the coupling. So this is the schematic geometry we analyzed. We have implemented a sealing model, a literature sealing model within the finite thermal code simulation. And finally, these are the results of our sealing motor. And we have identified the optimal geometry in terms of contact surface geometry. And okay, this is basically the result they want at CERN. I mean, all the coupling we have analyzed. This is a prototype vacuum chamber. Here, this is the ring, the SMA ring. And these are the pipes, the steel pipes. We did the leak tightness measurements by using a helium detector needle, and all the coupling are leak tight. So, but this is a very interesting work we are currently doing. This system will be, the idea is to install this system in the critical radioactive area of the accelerator. And there, we have to consider the possible damage, material damage, caused by irradiation. That's why we are currently studying the effect of irradiation. We did a numerical simulation, they did maybe a numerical simulation by using the Monte Carlo method implemented in a specific code. It is called Fluke. I don't know if you know this software. And we have used an irradiation facility at CERN, which is called CHARM. And we did this experiment. We simulated a total dose, which correspond to an exposure of about 1 year in the future development of the accelerator. And we repeated the leak tightness test and dismountability after exposure in radioactive environment. With day, because
the material that is activated is can should be managed according to very rigid procedures, and that's all. We are continuing with these experiments, and this is very nice.